Let's have a look at the next element now. Well, sodium. Sodium doesn't combine with nitrogen. It doesn't burn in nitrogen. It doesn't react with the nitrogen from the air. But it is possible to make a compound between sodium and nitrogen, just not by combining them directly. Okay? So it is possible to make a compound, and this compound is very, very different. Before, we saw the lithium nitride, and this had the chemical formula, it was Li3N. So there were three lithiums and one nitrogen. Well, the compound that we can make between sodium and nitrogen, not by directly combining the elements though, but the compound that we can get is called sodium azide, and this has one sodium and three nitrogens. So this is the structure there. All the nitrogens, the three nitrogens are in a row, so there's a unit of three nitrogens there with one overall negative charge, and the sodium, as usual, has lost its electron. It's given them to the nitrogens there to form a positive ion, sodium plus. Sodium azide. Well, watch what happens when we heat up some sodium azide. So in the tube here, we have a small quantity of sodium azide, and this is a white solid, so this is in the bottom of the tube. I'm going to heat this up. This is just to make sure that no gases come backwards, no water comes into the apparatus here, but we will be collecting any gases that are formed by displacing the water in this tube. So I'm just going to heat up the sodium azide. So just warming it, and you can see that maybe it's just because the air is expanding, a few bubbles have come up. Just keep on heating. Oh, and all of a sudden, look at the gas that's being formed. We're seeing a black colour forming in the tube here. The black colour is actually due to metallic sodium. And the gas that's forming over here is nitrogen gas. So what's taken place here, the sodium azide has decomposed to form sodium, and that's the black colour that you're seeing here. We've got metallic sodium, pure sodium. Maybe it's beginning to react with the glass. Okay, but we're also forming nitrogen gas. This reaction has been responsible for saving thousands of lives. And Chris will show us how. So here comes Chris. And with his little car here, well, this contains some sodium azide. The sodium azide is in the steering wheel. It's in the airbag. Okay, the airbag contains sodium azide. And under the right circumstances, we can trigger the release, the rapid release of that nitrogen gas to form sodium and nitrogen. The sodium then reacts further with other chemicals that are added in there. It actually contains essentially sand to react with the sodium. The sodium steals the oxygen from that in the way that we've seen with the glass. But this produces a lot of nitrogen gas very, very quickly. So are you ready for this then, Chris? Okay, we'll have a countdown from three. Don't blink, otherwise you'll miss it. This is the decomposition of sodium azide to initially form sodium and lots of nitrogen gas. So three, two, one. There we are. And you see, Panda is perfectly safe. Yes. Okay, of course, now that sounds very loud. But believe me, apparently, when you're, if you're unfortunate enough to actually have one of these things go off, the last thing you're worried about is the noise from the airbag, okay? But as I say, this has saved many, many lives. It needs to go off incredibly quickly, so actually, when you hit the airbag, it's not blowing up, it's actually going down again, it's deflating, so you have a nice soft landing on your airbag. So that's the compound formed between sodium and nitrogen. But as I say, we can't make this simply by combining sodium with nitrogen. Quite the reverse. We see that it decomposes on warming to reform the sodium and releasing this nitrogen gas.